As of 2020, India stood at rank 142 out of 180 countries in the World Freedom of Press Index. But did you know that freedom of press is fundamental to any democratic society? Freedom of press is the right of newspapers, magazines, etc. to report news without being controlled by the government. So why is the world's biggest democracy faring so poorly in the Freedom of Press Index? Reporters Without Borders cites the following reasons for violation in press freedom: police violence against journalists, retaliation by corrupt officials, and making it impossible for journalists to cover news in Kashmir by refusing access to mobile and internet services for several months. Reporters Without Borders continues to say, "Those who espouse the Hindutva ideology are trying to purge all manifestations of anti-national thought from the national debate. The coordinated hate campaigns waged on social networks against journalists are alarming and include calls for the journalists concerned to even be murdered. The campaigns are particularly virulent when the targets are women." There are three main ways freedom of press is restricted in India. The Unlawful Activities Prevention Act, meant to protect against any attacks to India's sovereignty and integrity, the UAPA law is being grossly misused to curb dissent. As of 2019, the law was amended to provide absolute power to the state, which means that it can label anyone as a terrorist without following due procedure or allowing the accused to redress. Most recently, Kashmiri photojournalist Masrat Zahra was charged under this law for uploading photos which document the daily excesses committed by the Indian security forces in Kashmir. Her posts were defined as anti-national. Anand Telthambe, a renowned Indian scholar and civil rights activist, said that the state is misusing the draconian law like the UAPA to terrorize people into silence by targeting select intellectuals and activists. Section 124A, the Sedition Law. Sedition is when any person, by words, by signs, visible representation or otherwise, attempts to bring hatred or contempt towards the government established by law in India. It is a non-bailable offence with a prison term which could last from 3 years to a lifelong term, and the accused can be called to court at any time. The Supreme Court stated as early as 1962 that sedition could be invoked only when persons call for the violent overthrow of government. But in India, this law is used to silence any criticism of the government, which is crucial to the maintenance of democratic values. Threat to life and well-being of journalists. Journalists in India are under threat of being attacked or murdered. We all know about the case of Gauri Lankesh, who was assassinated outside of her home while returning from work. It is widely believed that her assassination had to do with the fact that she was a staunch critic of the Hindutva government. This goes to show the immense intolerance India has towards honest journalism and the steps it will go to silence it. So how much can we believe the news we see in a country that punishes honest reportage?